فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My beloved brothers and sisters, the question that presents itself, إن السؤال المطروح الآن, the question that presents itself بإلحاح, that presents itself vigorously, is هل أخذنا بأسباب القبول بعد رمضان. Recently, a month or less than a month ago, we were blessed, we were honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be those who fasted in the month of Ramadan. We were blessed, we were honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to pray at night in the month of Ramadan. Now Ramadan has gone. We have now entered a new month. We are in the month of Shawwal. Are we people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted from them the month of Ramadan? Have we come with the actions and the speeches that will allow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept Ramadan from us? Ya ikhwati al-kiram, my beloved brothers and sisters, the question that we need to ask ourselves is also, هَلْ تَأَسَيْنَا بِالسَّلَفِ الصَّالِحِ. Have we treaded on the path of the pious predecessors, the people in which we were commanded to follow? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, أَثَرْ which is مَوْقُوف وَلَا يَصِحُ مَرْفُوعًا. A statement which is attributed to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. And those who try to make it the statement of the Messenger, then they are incorrect in this. That Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, مَنْ كَانَ مُسْتَنَّا فَلْيَسْتَنَّ بِمَنْ قَدْ مَاتِ. Anyone who wants to hold on to someone, then you should hold on to the early generation, the companions, the students of the companions, and the students of the companions. Have we followed the advice of this noble companion, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud? Have we followed the path of the pious predecessors? Or are we on a path different to theirs? In what matter am I speaking about in following the pious predecessors? The pious predecessors, my beloved brothers and sisters, they were scared, they were worried, they were concerned. Their hearts were in a state of fear whether Ramadan was accepted from them. And that is a question that they would ask themselves consistently and continuously. And they would make sure that when Ramadan had gone, the month that came after Shawwal, and if I'm not wrong, today is the 26th of Shawwal. There's only 4 days or 3 days remaining from the month. A believer had to have fasted the 6 days that come after Ramadan. A believer longs and remembers in his mind that Ramadan. If you look at the situation of many Muslims, you find that they have forgotten Ramadan. They are treating it as though it was years ago. Hafidh ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahimahullah, in his great noble book, Lataif al-Ma'arif, He mentions عن معلى ابن الفضل رحمه الله. He said أنهم كانوا يدعون الله. The Salaf, the pious predecessors who I just mentioned that we should take their path. They were كانوا يدعون الله ستة أشهر أن يتقبله منهم. They used to supplicate to Allah 6 months after Ramadan. They would cry to Allah 6 months after Ramadan. They are still consistent. Some of you are probably looking at me now and saying, Ramadan is long gone. Why are you doing a khutbah on this topic? But for 6 months after Ramadan, they will still be making the dua of what? أَن يَتَقَبَّلَهُ مِنْهُمْ. That Allah accepts Ramadan from them. كانوا, they were, رحمهم الله, يجتهدون في إتمام العمل وإكماله وإتقانه ثم يهتمون بعد ذلك بقبوله ويخافون من رده. They were, رحمهم الله, once when Ramadan came, they would fast properly, they would stand correctly, and after Ramadan went, they were scared, they were worried, they were concerned, they would consistently ask themselves, was Ramadan accepted? And they would make sure that Ramadan had not left their minds. ولذلك عائشة, our mother and the wife of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, سألت عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها الصديقة بنت الصديق. عائشة, the truthful one, the daughter of the truthful one, Abu Bakr. She asked him about the ayah, والذين يؤتون ما آتوا وقلوبهم وجلة. Aisha asked the messenger about this verse and what it means. She said, أَهُمُ الَّذِينَ يَزْنُونَ وَيَسْرِقُونَ وَيَشْرَبُونَ. Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها, she said, are they the ones who commit zina? Are they the ones who steal? Are they the ones who do fornication? And then they are scared. Because what the ayah says is, those who come with what they came with and they are scared. Their heart is in a state of fear. So Aisha said, is it the ones who commit zina, the ones who steal, and the ones who drink khamar? Is it those ones that Allah is talking about in this verse? And the messenger said, La yabnat as-siddiq. No, the daughter of Abu Bakr. ولكنهم الذين يصلون ويصومون ويتصدقون ويخافون ألا يتقبل منهم. They are the ones who pray, they fast, they give in charity, and they are scared that it won't be accepted from them. We should be in that state. Is our action going to be accepted? يقول علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه, علي رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, كونوا لقبول العمل أشد. علي بن أبي طالب said, Be people, كونوا لعمل القلب, كونوا لقبول العمل أشد اهتماما منكم بالعمل. Be more concerned with the acceptance of the action than coming with the action itself alone. ألم تسمعوا, علي said, have you not heard, إلى قول الله عز وجل, the statement of Allah, إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. Allah, He accepts from those who are pious. So if you see that an action of yours is accepted, it's an indication that you're a person who has taqwa. So they knew that if the action was accepted from them, they have come with piety. وقال وعن الفضيل بن عياض أما sorry وعن فضالة بن عبيد رضي الله تعالى عنه. فضالة said, لو أني أعلم, if I was to know, أن الله تقبل مني مثقال حبة خردل. He said, if I was to know that Allah accepted from me a mustard seed of righteous deed, أحب إلي من الدنيا وما فيها, it is more beloved to me than this dunya and everything in it. لأن الله يقول, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. Allah, He accepts from those who are pious. وقال عطاء, عطاء said, الحذر الاتقاء على العمل ألا يكون لله. To be concerned and to be worried that an action is not going to be for Allah. He's not going to accept it. وقال ابن دينار, ابن دينار, he said, عمرو بن دينار, الخوف على العمل ألا يتقبل أشد من العمل. Fear that the action, fear, الخوف على العمل, fear for the action, for it not to be accepted, is greater than coming with the action itself. أيها المسلمون, O Muslims, يَا مَنْ إِسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِرَبِّكُمْ. Those of you who obeyed their Lord في Ramadan, إِسْتَجِيبُوا لَهُ فِي سَائِرِ الْأَيَّامِ. Obey your Lord in other months other than Ramadan. إِسْتَجِيبُوا لِرَبِّكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ يَوْمٌ لَا مَرَدَّ لَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Obey Allah. Go back to your Lord. Follow His command before there comes a day where you will not turn back to Him. أَيُّهَا الْإِخْوَةُ فِي اللَّهِ. My beloved brothers and sisters, لَقَدْ جَاءَتِ النُّصُوصِ. Many textual evidences have come that speak about worshipping Allah, being upright and steadfast, not specific to the month of Ramadan, but rather the Lord of Ramadan is the Lord of every other month in the year. ولذلك أبو بكر رضي الله تعالى عنه, when the people cried over the Prophet's death and they became sad, they lost the most honorable man that ever walked on the face of this earth, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Abu Bakr reminded them something. He said to them, من كان يعبد محمد, anybody who was worshipping Muhammad, فإن محمدا قد مات, then Muhammad نعم is dead. ومن كان يعبد الله, فإن الله حي لا يموت. But the one who obeys Allah and the one who is worshipping Allah, then Allah is not one that dies. So I want to say to you all, the one that was worshipping Allah in Ramadan alone, then remember the Lord of Ramadan is the Lord of every other month. So you don't just worship Him in Ramadan. You don't just come to the congregation in Ramadan alone. You don't just read Quran in the month of Ramadan. The Lord of Ramadan is the Lord of every other month. يقول حسن البصري, حسن البصري said, رحمه الله, لا يكون لعمل المؤمن أجل. Hassan al-Basri said that the action of the believer has no restricted time دون الموت besides death. There is not a time where your actions is restricted to. Naam, there are times your actions increase and you multiply your efforts, but that doesn't mean there's ever a time where you stop acting. There's not a time when you stop working hard. وَقَرَأَ قَوْلَهُ. He recited the statement of Allah, وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship your Lord until certainty comes to you. And yaqeen here means certainty as in death. وَسُئِلَ بِشْرِ الْحَافِي. Bishr al-Hafi was asked, رحمه الله, عَنْ أُنَاسِ يَتَعَبَّدُونَ فِي رَمَضَانَ. A people who are worshipping Allah in Ramadan. وَيَجْتَهِدُونَ. And they are working hard in the month of Ramadan. فَإِذَا انْسَلَخَ رَمَضَانَ تَرَكُوا. When the month of Ramadan leaves, they leave the masajid. They leave the obedient acts that they were doing. قَالَ. He said, بِئْسَ الْقَوْمُ. Evil are these people. لَا يَعْرِفُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا فِي رَمَضَانَ. They don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except in the month of Ramadan. يَقُولُ كَعَبْ. Ka'ab said, مَنْ صَامَ رَمَضَانَ. Anyone who fasts in the month of Ramadan, وَهُوَ يُحَدِّثُ نَفْسَهُ. And he tells himself, and now إِذَا خَرَجَ رَمَضَانَ, that when Ramadan goes, عَصَى رَبَّهُ, that I'm going to disobey Allah. فَصِيَامُهُ عَلَيْهِ مَرْدُودٌ. Then his fasting is rejected in his face. وَبَابُ التَّوْفِيقِ فِي وَجْهِهِ مَزْدُودٌ. And the ability to be upright and righteousness will also be blocked from him. So I want to say to you, my beloved brothers and sisters, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَاثًا. And do not be like the woman who untwisted her spun after she made it strong. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. My beloved brothers and sisters, حاسبوا أنفسكم رحمكم الله. Account yourselves, put yourself on accountability. After the fasting of Ramadan, after the ending of this month that we fasted 6 extra days. After that, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and account yourself. Question yourselves. Ya ikhwati al-kiram, my beloved brothers and sisters, people who own businesses, every year they do a calculation of what they have done that year. And they calculate their efforts. How much profit have they made? How much losses have they made? And they think about what was the problems and what were the pros and what were the cons. The believer sits down and he accounts himself. He questions himself and he says, what was it that I did right? And what was it that I did wrong? And what is it that I need to work on? فَانْظُرُوا, also look at my beloved brothers. مَاذَا قَدَّمْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ. Ask yourselves and look at what have you put forward. What is it that awaits you the day of judgment? The day when there is no money or wealth or children are going to benefit you. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَعَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. A day when children and wealth and everything is not going to benefit you except the person who comes with, the one that comes with a pure heart. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ أَجِسَامِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَعَمَالِكُمْ. Allah does not look at your physique. Allah does not look how big and strong you are. Allah doesn't look at your wealth. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will look at your heart and He will look at that which has manifested on your limbs, the actions that you have come with. The thing that Allah looks at is the heart of the person and the action which they have come with. So you need to make sure that today that you observe what your heart is upon and the situation of your heart, and you also look at your actions and that which you're coming with. My beloved brothers and sisters, everything that you own today will no longer be yours once you die. You're not going to possess it, it is not yours. Your children are not going to be yours anymore once you're dead. Your wealth is not going to be yours. Even before you become placed in your grave, you even lose your name. The people won't refer to you by your name. They will say, lift the dead body. Your name is now called the dead body. Turn over the dead body. Have you washed the face of the dead body? Have you made sure that you've done this for the dead body? You've lost everything. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions that even your shadow, it leaves you at times. Everything which you own will go. The only thing, my beloved brothers and sisters, that is going to remain with you is your actions, your righteous deeds, the a'mal that you have come with. This is your true friend. Youngsters, don't you say, this person is my friend because he has gone through thick and thin with me. Well then, what's going to go through thick and thin with you is your righteous deeds, your actions. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, يَتَّبِعُ الْمَيِّتُ ثَلَاثٌ. Three are what go with a person. فَيَرْجِعُ اثْنَانٌ. Two come back. وَيَبْقَى وَاحِدٌ. Two are going to come back and one is going to remain. And the one that's going to remain is your actions. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. Fear Allah. Fear Him privately and fear Him publicly. The Messenger told us in a hadith, Al-Imam al-Tabarani narrated in his Mu'jam, Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani, he authenticated this hadith bi mujma'i turuqiha, when all of the narrations were brought together, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that there's going to come a people, they have a'mal, actions that are as big as the mountain of Tahama. This is a big mountain. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he told us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to nullify all their righteous deeds. All of it is going to go. So the companions, they asked, they said, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, are these people not believers? Do they not believe in Allah and the Day of Judgment? The Messenger said, of course they are believers. They believe in Allah and they believe in the Day of Judgment. But even then, their righteous deeds will be nullified. The Messenger even added on to saying, يُصَلُّونَ كَمَا. They pray the way you pray. وَيَصُومُونَ. And they fast the way you fast. They come with the deeds that you guys come with. وَلَهُمُ الْحَظُّ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. And even at night, they pray قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. So they have a portion of the night which they remember Allah. But the problem and the reason, the underlining reason why their righteous deeds was nullified, all of it is, وَلَكِنَّهُمْ إِذَا خَلَوْا بِمَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ انْتَهَكُوهَا. But the problem was, when they were alone privately, they didn't remember Allah, they didn't fear Him, and they were not conscious of Him. My young brothers and sisters who are spending their holiday, their summer holiday, on social media, talking about things that don't concern them and indulging in things that the Day of Judgment will not please them, remember, وَلَكِنَّهُمْ إِذَا خَلَوْا بِمَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ انْتَهَكُوهَا. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can see. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدٌ مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Everything will be documented, and the day of judgment you're going to see. مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. Everything which you said and spoke about is going to be placed in front of you. This advice, first of all, goes to me before anybody else. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes us those who follow that which they preach. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ighfir lana hazlana wa jiddana wa khata'ana wa amdana wa kullu thalika indana ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma la taj'ali al-dunya akbar hammina ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. ربي آتي نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.